Hey there, folks. Lenny Rudo here for BoatUS Magazine. Today, we're going to talk compression checks. Everybody hears about a compression check, and everyone knows when you buy a boat with a used outboard on it, you should get a compression check. Well, why is that? We have outboard technician Sean Stahl here with us today to tell us, why should you get a compression check?
You want to get a compression test because you basically want to see how much life the engine still has. You want to see how much wear is on the piston and the piston rings. And you want to see how much air is being pushed through the engine. The engine's a giant air pump is what it is.
And how does the compression test tell you? What do you look for during the test?
What you're looking for is you're looking at the PSI in each cylinder. So if one cylinder is 120, you want to go off that cylinder and base it off of 10%. They want to be within 10% of one another.
So every cylinder should have about 10% the same amount of pressure.
Correct. So if one cylinder is at 120, all the other cylinders relatively should be between 110 PSI to 120 PSI.
Gotcha. Okay, Sean, let's get started. Show me what to do.
All right. So the first thing we're gonna do is pull off this cover right here. It's pretty easy sometimes. So there's that. All right, then you got four 10 millimeter bolts. Let's take those out.
And of course, different engines will have different access points to get to the plugs.
Correct.
And we're doing this on a...
This is a 175 Yamaha inline four. Now they're out of the way. Then the next thing we're gonna wanna do is pull the plugs. And the plugs usually are a 5/8 socket.
And so even though you only compression test one cylinder at a time, you pull all the plugs out right from the start.
Correct.
And why is that?
It's just so the engine doesn't fire. It allows max air, or the maximum amount of air to get into the engine. Because like I said before, like the engine's a giant air pump. You want to get as much air into the engine as possible. That way you get a good accurate reading.
I imagine it would be quite a mess if it actually fired off. Now, what about fuel? Isn't fuel flowing into the cylinders when you do this?
That is correct. Usually what I normally do is on the side of the engine, there's a 15 amp fuse for the fuel pump. I'll unplug, take the 15 amp fuse out to keep the fuel pump from pumping fuel into the cylinders.
Gotcha. So there's no fuel actually moving through the motor when you're doing this.
Correct. Because if you get fuel into the cylinders, it will wash out your readings. They'll vary.
So this is your gauge here. What are we looking at?
All right. So this is the compression gauge right here. As you can see, it has your PSI readings on here ranging from 25 all the way to 300. When we're doing the compression test, it's just going to trap the air inside and give you a good accurate reading on how much air is being pushed through the cylinder.
And how does that attach into where the spark plug was?
So the way it attaches is you have this piece right here. This is the end. It almost looks like an air hose end to it. Mm-hmm. This end will go in here, and then this end will actually go into the cylinder for the spark.
Let's do it up.
All right.
Let's see it.
So usually what I do is I leave the end off first, then I will twist this in to the cylinder until it gets tight, and then just clip this on.
Excellent.
Leave it sitting there, and then I would do my compression test. Good. And that cylinder's at 200. Good. All right.
Okay, Sean, so that's our compression test. Now, we should mention that before you do it, the engine has to be...
hot.
Right, it should be warmed up ahead of time.
Correct.
So what did we learn?
All four cylinders are at 200 PSI, so they're definitely well within 10% of one another, and this engine's got a lot of life left.
Excellent, which is no shocker since this is a brand new motor.
Correct.
Well, folks, we hope you've enjoyed this video, and we hope you'll leave any comments you might have in the spot below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to the BoatUS YouTube channel. Thanks a lot.